Hello friends, I welcome you to my YouTube channel MacPM. So in today's video we will solve a simple problem based on stress and strain. In this problem you have this LMNP bar which is of bearing area and it is subjected to axial loads, and we have to calculate pressure P, this pressure P, sorry, force P to maintain the equilibrium, and total elongation in the bar. Value of A is given. So see, to calculate the force P, we can just maintain the equilibrium in F direction. Sum of all the forces in F direction should be 0. So you can see 500, suppose in left direction it is plus, so 50 is plus, minus P plus, this is left direction, so it is 500 plus, minus, this is in opposite direction, so it is minus 200 equal to 0. So 550 minus 200 minus P is equal to 0. So P is equal to, this P will come this side, it will become 350 kilonewton. So this P is 350 kilonewton. So we have already solved first part, or we can do one more thing, that we will separate these three blocks. This is LM, this is MM, and this is NP. Okay, so here we can say 200 kilonewton. So to maintain equilibrium, this side also it should be 200. So here it is 200, but here you can see in the diagram it is written 500. So 200 is here, so remaining 300 should be in this direction. So here it is 300, so here also it should be 300, but here it is written P, and here it is 50 kilonewton. So here also it should be 50 kilonewton. So here it is 50, here it is 300. Both will add because they are in the same direction. So this P should be 350. Now what we have to calculate? See, we have to calculate total elongation of the bar. Force P we have already calculated. A is 210 giga newton per meter square. A is equal to 210 giga newton per meter square. So elongation is delta L is equal to delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3. Suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So we will add elongation of all the blocks. Now you can see that this one is having compressive force, so this its length will contract, not elongate, it will just contract because compressive forces are acting. So it will become delta L1 minus delta L2 plus delta L3. Now E is equal to, from Hooke's law, E is equal to stress upon strain, which is equal to P by A is stress divided by delta L upon L is strain. So E is equal to PL upon A delta L. So delta L is equal to PL upon AE. Okay. So we will calculate every delta L for each part. Delta L1 is P1 L1 upon A1 E. E is same for, so we will not even write E1 into it because E is same for each part. So it will become, you can see here P1 is 50 kilonewton. So 50 into 10 to the power 3 newton into L1 is 1000 mm, which is equal to 1 meter. divided by A1 is given 600 mm square, which is equal to 600 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square, because we are converting meter square into mm square into meter square, because each thing is in meter, everything is in meter, into A is 210 into 10 to the power 9. So if you will calculate it, then you will get 3.97 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, and it is plus because length is increasing. Similarly, delta L2, I will just put it downward so that we can easily see. First is this one, delta L1. Now delta L2 will be equal to PL upon A, P2 L2 upon A2E is equal to 350 into 10 to the power 10 to the power 3, because it is in kilonewton, into L2 is 1 meter, divided by A2 is given as 2400 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square, into E is 210 into 10 to the power 9. So it will become 5.95 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, and it will be negative because it is under contraction. And third part, delta L3, it is compressive, for that why it is negative. P3 L3 upon A3 E, which is equal to P3 is 200 kilonewton, so 200 into 10 to the power 3 into L is 0.6 meter, divided by A is 1200 into 10 to the power minus 6 into E is 210 into 10 to the power 9. So if you will calculate this, then you will get the value of delta L3, which is equal to 4.76 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, which is plus because it is under tension. So if you calculate total elongation, so delta L is equal to delta L1 minus delta L2 plus delta L3, which is equal to 3.97 minus 5.95 plus 4.76, 10 into 10 to the power minus 4 is common in each, so it will be equal to 2.78 into 10 to the power minus 4 or 0.278 mm. This will be the value of elongation, total elongation in the bar. So I hope you understood up to here and how to solve this problem. If you have any doubt, then please ask in the comment section, and if you liked our video, then please share and subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.